How's it going, everybody? Rob here, back with some more of Borderlands 3. Okay, so I kinda just want to explore for a bit.
Fresh water. There must be a settlement somewhere nearby.
Okay. Just kind of exploring this place. See if there's anything I missed.
No hope of clearing this without a shovel.
Now I have a shovel. Let's see.
Thank you.
These tracks.
Midges.
Goblins?
Shouldn't nature be beautiful and serene? It looks so nice in the upper city parts.
Glowing eyes are rarely a good sign. Let's be careful.
Let's see.
What's that?
Let's see. That freaking hurt. Alright, let's head back the way we came.
smell only fear. The fear of cowards lying for an ambush.
You can take a day off once in a while, Lazelle.
I do not take days off. I'd even forego sleep if such a thing were feasible. The one advantage an elf holds over a githyanki.
Alright, let's fast travel here. And this thing's confusing sometimes. So I need to find So where is the entrance to this? Okay, let's see. I think this is what it was. The old temple.
Something underneath here.
There we go.
Copper for your thoughts.
That fight at the toll house really heated you up, didn't it?
What about it? Had to let off a little steam after facing off with those ignots. Granted, the fire lasted a little longer than it should.
How could you withstand the heat?
Hear that? Infernal engine for a heart. Lets me burn as hot as the hells. Seems to be running in overdrive since I left Avernus. Won't be seeing my mechanic anytime soon, so I'll just make the most of the extra heat. Just don't get too close till I've found a way to calm it down.
How the hells did you get an infernal engine of her heart?
High pain tolerance. And a dynamic duo of truly shitty bosses. But it's a bit early in the game to be getting into tragic backstories. Let's save the scar show for later. After we've worked up an appetite for tragedy. Meanwhile, I'll need to find someone who can tune up my engine sooner rather than later. Believe me when I say this thing is hot. The first time I faced down those paladins, they let slip there was an infernal mechanic in the area, a tiefling. He might be able to stabilize things, if I can find him.
Let's see.
Sounds like a good lead. Hopefully our guy will be among them. A tune-up would do this old tub a world of good.
Okay. All right, let's let's see.
May the gods take you first.
Let's turn someone inside out.
This will do nicely.
Yes. Over there.
Okay, I want to try something. All right, firebolt. There we go.
Position.
Got him that time. Alright, let's set up a camp. Let's see. All right, just looking around. Be nice to get a freaking merchant here to sell my wares, you know? Who's this?
The Blade of Frontiers. Thought I'd shaken you for good after the Mind Flayer ship. You just can't get enough of me, can you?
Karlak, Advocatus Diaboli, the stink of Avernus.
I remember you from the Goblin fight at the Grove.
Pride of the coast, in the flesh, and you've got...
A great fire roars through you, the fire of the first hell. You are the Blade of Frontiers, racing through the wastes of Avernus. Just ahead, a diabolical figure, red skin, single curled horn, blazes with flame, bloodied great axe held high. He chases the fiend, ignited with rancor. She is an infernal war devil, a threat to the living, evil incarnate.
Your allies are fraud, a soldier in the archdevil Zariel's army. Either I cut her down, or she burns the Sword Coast to ash.
I've tried to tell you, I am not what you think I am.
Another vision. Karlak's blade raised, slicing through devils, Zariel's servants, as her eyes dart around, seeking escape. The man shudders with Karlak's desperation. She is a victim of the Blood War, not an agent of it.
By Baldrin's helm, I... No. I will not be tricked.
You saw the truth. I may be an effective soldier, but I never wanted to serve Zariel. Legged it away from her the first chance I got.
And yet you served.
Be practical. We're infected. You're infected, same as us. You need allies, not enemies.
The man catches his breath and his lips straighten. Sheer dread twists his face.
No! Devils cannot be trusted.
You saw Karlak's thoughts. She poses no threat to the Sword Coast.
Would you listen to sense? This doesn't have to end badly for either of us. You know monsters, right? Better than anyone. Look into my eyes. Can't you see I'm not what you think?
Shit. You really are no devil, are you? I've been deceived.
Thank the gods. Thought I was gonna have to take your head.
You would have died in the attempt. But there have been enough threats today. Truce?
I'll do you one better. Allies, we're looking to get rid of these parasites for good and ruin some bastards' days while we're at it. Sounds like your kind of venture.
I've not grown any tentacles yet, thank Baldrin. But luck won't be on our side forever. Yes, you have my blade. Your leader willing, of course.
Well, soldier, what's the word?
Yep. The more the merrier, as they say.
Hey!
Well met, and a thousand sorries. I've pledged my life to protecting the meek from monsters. But tonight, I was the rampaging beast. I see the good in you, Karlak. I promise not to lose sight of it, even when the hells burn hottest.
The famous Blade of Frontiers in the flesh. Clever, this hero act you've got going.
Hero, blade, name strangers gave me. My friends call me Will.
Excellent. If we ever become friends, I'll know what to call you.
Ooh.
Glad Will saw sense. Even more glad he decided to stick around. Takes a pretty slick mover to track down old Karlak.
I'm glad he's joined us. Glad you two could make peace.
Same. Now, instead of a liability, I've got a friend. Or I will have soon, anyway.
The Githyanki people have a word for men like the Blade of Frontiers. Shalark, roughly translated, idealist do-gooder, or better yet, benevolent burden. His confidence is an asset, his pursuit of valor, not so much.
Okay.
You've been witness to a pantomime, I'm sorry to say. And I've played my part all too poorly.
What's that supposed to mean? Someone set you on Karlak's table. I'd like to know who.
I can say only this. Karlak's not the only one who's had a villain's knife held to their throats. One night soon, when we make camp, the veil will be lifted, and I'll pay my penance.
Penance? Should I be worried?
You're not in any danger. I promise. I can't say the same about me.
Okay.
Hope you're keeping well, friend.
All right. Let's get back out of here. Okay. So, seems we've come across some more stuff for this area. So, I think for now, I'm gonna end it here. We'll explore it in the next video. Till then, thank you guys so much for watching. Truly appreciate it. If you guys can, please leave a like, comment, share, subscribe, all the good stuff. If you guys want to follow us on social media, links are in the description down below. As well as check out our daily content and the weekly podcast. With that being said, this is Rob Novakast signing off. Have a good one. Take care. And I'll see you guys next video.